First of all, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, we are grateful this morning for gathering us into your presence. We thank you, Lord, for awakening each and every one of us to have a sweet fellowship with you this morning. This morning, Lord, let your word have its free course. Holy Spirit, we ask that you have your way with us this morning. Empower us. Keep us a hearing ear and a hearing heart to be receptive to your word this morning. And let the name of our Lord Jesus be glorified in our midst as we've gathered before you this morning. We thank you, mighty Lord, for this privilege, for this opportunity. We bless your holy name for it. The word says you have not called us to seek you in vain. Therefore, Lord, we have that assurance that each and every one of us is going to leave your presence refreshed, is going to leave your presence empowered, is going to leave your presence engraced, is going to leave your presence a different man, a different woman, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. We bless your holy name for it in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Another exciting, awesome time in the presence of the living God. Let's go before him this morning as we lift up our voices, put on our dancing shoes, and praise and worship him with these songs.
In your presence, for the things he's brought.
Trusting you to hear my yes and lead me on. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. My life is yours.
I'll just say
yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. This life you gave is not my own.
I'm trusting you to hear my yes and lead me on.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah. say it again.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We're going to our general prayers this morning. Sister Lydia will be leading us in that. Let's receive and welcome her.
Good morning. Today in our morning devotion prayers, we will be praying for the morning devotion platform. Okay. In our first prayer, let us thank God for this morning devotion program that He by Himself has set up for us to encounter Him and be refreshed. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we honor You. We thank You so much, even for the opportunity of giving us a platform to gather together. We thank You, God, for this morning devotion program that You have designed for us, O God. You set this up for us, God, that we may have even a mountain of refreshing, that we can come every morning and gather before You and be refreshed in Your presence, O God. And so we honor You, my God. We thank You, my Father, that, Lord, You have chosen us even to be able to come and encounter You every day, that our lives may be transformed every morning, every time we come before You. And Lord, what an honor it is, what a privilege, oh God. And Father, we just want to thank You that, God, You have thought about us, and that, Lord, You chose to create this platform, that, Father, we can come together, and that we can even invite more and more family members, oh God. And the more people that come, they really do find that it is a place of refreshment, oh God. And so we thank You, my Father, we honor You, that, God, You are such a wonderful Father. Thank You for Your provision to us. Amen. In our second prayer, let us uproot every plan of the wicked to hinder or limit the program, the progress of this program in any way, and decree them null and void in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Father, this morning, we come before You and we uproot every plan of the wicked one to hinder or to limit the program of this morning devotion program in any way. And Father, we decree them null and void in the name of Jesus. Your word tells us in Jeremiah 1:10, see, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down, and to destroy, and to throw down, to build, and to plant. Father, we thank You. We honor You, God. We pray this morning that, Father, even we come before You to uproot every plan of the wicked one, oh God, to uproot, to pull down, to destroy every plan that hinders the progress of this morning devotion program, oh God. And that, Father, we decree every one of those schemes and devices null and void, oh God, even in the name of Jesus. And today that, Father, even this morning program will be a place to build and to plant, oh God, even that which You have planned for us, oh Lord. We thank You and we honor You today. In our third prayer, let us commit this program into God's hand, that He will continue to enlarge and to prosper it, bringing its impact to every part of this nation and beyond. Let us pray. Our Father, we commit this program into your hands. Thank you for giving us a program such as this one, oh Lord. And Father, we thank you and we pray for its enlargement and we pray for its prosperity, my God, that Father, it will bring impact to every part of this nation and beyond, oh Lord. Your word tells us, commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in him and he shall bring it to pass. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light and thy judgment as the noonday. Also, your word tells us in Proverbs 16, verse 3, commit thy works unto the Lord and thy thoughts shall be established. So, Father, today we commit this program to you, O God, that you may establish it, O God, that you may enlarge it and prosper it, O God, beyond the bounds of our environment, O God, even beyond this nation, beyond our cities, O God, and even to the utmost parts of the world, my God. We commit this program to you, Lord, because, Father, you will set forth our righteousness as the light and your judgment and our judgments as the noonday, O God. And so as we prosper it, as we bring it to you, that our thoughts may be established, O God, that your ways, as we commit our ways to you, that, Lord, you will establish them even through this program, God, that because we come before you every morning and because you have created such a place for us to gather, that, Lord, your presence being with us always and all the time, God, will create such an impact, oh God, that will be felt all over the world. In Jesus' name, amen. In our fourth prayer today, let us ask the Father of Lights to impact us with his good and perfect gifts through this platform, and by it establish our good fortune among men. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. God, we honor you today. Father, we pray that, Father, even you being the Father of Lights, that, God, you will impact us with your good and perfect gifts, even through this morning devotion program, God. And that by those gifts that you give us, you will establish our good fortune among men. Your word tells us every good gift and every perfect gift is from above. And it comes down from the Father of Lights, with whom there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Father, we thank you that, God, all good gifts come from you, God. Everything that we experience on a daily basis, it comes from you, my God. All the good things that we receive, oh Lord, have come from you. And Father, as we receive these good and perfect gifts from you, Lord, as we receive them because of your ability to bless us on this platform, God, may you establish our good fortune among men. That, Father, men may see the good works that come from all this and believe in you, O God, and be drawn to the saving grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you and we honor you. Thank you, my God. We believe in you. We thank you. We know that, Father, you will establish our good fortune, O God. We trust in your ability, O God, because we see the goodness of God on a daily basis in our lives. We see your mercy, and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. In our fifth prayer, let us say, Father, release your wisdom upon the coordinator of this program, that in all things he shall be guided by the Spirit and empowered with grace for our profiting. In Jesus' name, let us pray. Our God and our Father, may you release your wisdom upon the coordinator of this program, Pastor Tunji. We thank you, God, for his ability to hear from you, God. And as he hears from you, my Father, that all the things that he shall do shall be guided by the Holy Spirit himself, even our comforter, our instructor, my God. And Father, that you will empower with him with grace, even for our profiting, God. We thank you for this opportunity, my God. And we ask, my Father, even as your word says, thus says the Lord, thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to profit, which leadeth thee by the way that thou should go. And in 1 Corinthians 12:7, your word says, but the manifestations of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal. So, Father, we honor you for your word. We thank you that, God, even by your spirit, as we call upon your name, that you will give our pastor, Pastor Tunji, God, even by the leading of your spirit, you shall guide him in his ability to even coordinate this program, oh Father, and empower him with grace that, God, every person that comes to this morning devotion program shall profit by it, oh Lord. We thank you, my God. We thank you for your word, and we honor you. Thank you, Jesus. In our sixth prayer, let us ask for fresh oil upon all the ministers on this platform for greater impact upon our lives in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Our Father, we honor you for every person that ministers on this program. We thank you that, God, you send us wonderful ministers, wonderful teachers that teach us in your ways. And so, my God, this morning, we ask that you pour a fresh oil upon all the ministers on this platform for a greater impact upon our lives. Your word tells us, but my horn shalt thou exalt like the horn of a unicorn. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Father, we thank you. This morning, we thank you for every member that comes to this platform and every minister that you send to us, my God. That, Father, that fresh oil shall be poured upon them, my God. And that, Father, as they minister to each one of us, God, that we will be impacted even for greater good. We honor you, my God. We thank you for your word, and we thank you for the oil of the Holy Spirit, just anointing each person on this platform, God, and causing us to be refreshed, to be empowered, to even be equipped for every good work that we do. We thank you, mighty God, and we honor you, Lord. We thank you in Jesus' name. Thank you. In our seventh prayer today, let us say, Father, open a highway for multitudes and hasten them to continue to access this program and bringing them by your hand in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Our Father, may you open a highway, O God, for multitudes that hear about this program that we invite, O God, day by day, Father, that we even testify to of the goodness of the Lord upon this program. Father, as they hear, and God, even by your Holy Spirit, that you will hiss to them to continue to access this program, O God, and that you will bring them even by your mighty hand, O Lord. We thank you, God. Your word tells us, and a highway shall be there, and a way, and it shall be called the highway of the way of holiness. The unclean shall not pass over it, but it shall be for those, the wayfaring men, though fools shall not err therein. God, I pray that, Father, even this highway that you have created, the Lord, you shall open it, O Lord, for the multitudes, O God. That, Father, those that hear about it, O Lord, those that are introduced to it, O God, those that receive invitations, Father, that as they hear this, as they hear us talking about it, as they hear us calling upon them to come, that Holy Spirit, you will even give them that nudge and that push to come and join this morning devotion program. And as they access your goodness on this program, my Father, as they see what you do, that even more shall be drawn to you, even by your hand, my God, because it is only your hand that can draw them, God. We only come because you have invited us, my Father. Your word says, turn, O backsliding children, said the Lord. I am married unto you, and I will take you, one of a city and two of a family, and I will bring you to Zion. So God, may you cause all these hearing ears, O Lord, those that hear, give them a hearing ear, O God, that Father, as they come, O Lord, they will come to Zion, even the city of the Lord, that they will come and they will be refreshed in amazing ways, O God, that only you can do by your hand. We honor you, Father. Thank you so much for this platform, God. Thank you for your mercy upon our lives. We honor you and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Our scripture reading this morning is from the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 30, from verse 1 to 8. Just the one you afraid we read for us.
Good morning. I'll be reading from King James Study Bible, 1 Samuel, chapter 30, 1 through 8. The Amalekites take Ziklag. And it came to pass when David and his men were come to Ziklag on the third day, that the Amalekites had invaded the south and smitten Ziklag and burned it with fire, and had taken the women captives that were therein. They slew not any, either great or small, but carried them away and went on their way. Verse 3. So David and his men came to the city, and behold, it was burned with fire, and their wives and their sons and their daughters were taken captives. Then David and the people that were with him lifted up their voice and wept until they had no more power to weep. And David's two wives were taken captives, Ahinoam, the Jezreelite, and Abigail, the wife of Nabal, the Carmelite. And David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him, because the soul of all the people was grieved, every man for his sons and for his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord his God. Verse 7, and David said to Abiathar the priest, Ahimelech's son, I pray thee, bring me hither an ephod. And Abiathar brought thither the ephod to David. And David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all. Amen.
Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God's word to us is to pursue his promises. Hallelujah. Pursue his promises. And in our pursuit, we must be well equipped to be able to pursue and obtain. So we are still talking about developing a hunting attitude. And we understood from yesterday that every born-again person, every Christian, every believer is a hunter. Because why? We go on a faith hunt. The promises of God are yes and amen. But for us to bring it into actualization, we use our faith. Hallelujah. We use our faith to hunt and to obtain the promises of God. And like we just read, we must understand that every hunter pursues their target. They don't wait for the target to come to them. They pursue their target. So we looked at the steps to a successful hunt, or you can call it steps to a successful faith hunt. Hallelujah. And the first thing we discussed yesterday was find what the word says, what the word says about your hunting target. Because like we saw yesterday in the natural, when someone is going on a hunt to hunt for whatever it is, he has a specific target in mind, and there's a specific area that he must hunt, because you don't have all these animals and stuff like that existing in all the areas. So you must first find what the word says about your hunting target. And the Bible is our area of hunting. That is where we go to locate where our specific target, what the word says about it. Hallelujah. So number two, we say, believe what the word says about the target. After you found what the word says about the hunting target, second thing is to believe what the word says. Jesus said, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believe. All things are possible to him that believes. Mark 11, 23, 24 says, paraphrasing, it says, if you shall believe that those things which you see it shall come to pass, you shall have whatsoever, hallelujah, whatsoever you say. And when you pray, you must what? Believe first. So the belief must be there before you even go to God. We'll get to that. So you must believe what the word says about the target. So you start talking to the mountain instead of talking about the mountain, because in the book of Proverbs 6:2, it says, thou art snared with the words of thy mouth. That means your words have formed a trap for you, and eventually you'll be caught in it. So thou art taken with the words of thy mouth. Hallelujah. So what you are saying, what you are speaking concerning the target determines what happens. Hallelujah. Jesus went again and in the book of Matthew 17:20, he said, Jesus said unto them, because of your unbelief, for verily I say unto you, if ye shall have faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye shall say unto this mountain, remove hence to yonder place, and it shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible unto you. And when we read this, sometimes we think, we look at a grain of mustard seed, and we think, oh, you need to have some sort of small faith. No, if you do further studies, you see that the mustard seed is a seed that cannot be cross-pollinated. Meaning what? It does not change no matter what. So that's why Jesus is saying, if you have faith as a grain of the mustard seed, we just not change. The faith that does not change no matter what, you will say, move to this mountain and it shall move. Hallelujah. It shall move. So anytime the truth is analyzed with a carnal mind before acting on it, it ceases to be truth anymore. It becomes, you know, mere information. Information does not carry power to set us free. 3, after you believed, settle with the word. Until the will of God is known, faith does not come alive. If you are not sure, for example, if you are not sure of me giving you something you are going to ask me for, you can't believe me for it. So until the will of God is known, faith does not come alive. And the will of God is what? His word. His word. Our faith cannot go beyond the question mark we have. As long as we are thinking whether it will happen or not, that is a question mark. And our faith cannot go beyond that because we cannot see beyond that. And the word in the Bible says, as far as your eyes can see, that's what you're going to possess. So settle on the word. Settle with the word. God does not change. So first, you do what? You find the target area where the word is concerned. You believe what the word says about that target area. And this could be any area of your life, any issue in your life, what the word says about it. Then you settle with the word. Now, having done all this, now you do what you ask. That is the prayer. That's when prayer comes in. You don't just get up and pray, because you pray according to the will of God, because that's what the Bible says. When we pray according to his will, he hears us. So that means if you pray not according to what his will is, which is his word, it doesn't go above the roof of your house. So you act and then you meditate on the target daily, right? John 14, 13 to 14 says, and whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If ye ask anything in my name, I will do it. Hallelujah. I will do it. Some people always struggle some with this, saying God knows all things, why should I ask him? But that's a spiritual principle, right? Solomon asked for wisdom to rule his people. He gave him. In the book of Ezekiel 36, 37, it says, I will yet for this be inquired of, right? He didn't just say, I will yet for this be inquired of, and then start. Do it for them. That's the process. They will come ask me first. He knows all things. He does not circumvent your will. Maybe you don't need it until you ask. Until you ask, he doesn't know whether you need it or not. So you must ask. I will be a yet for this inquire of them to do it for them. Hallelujah. To do it for them. In the book of Colossians chapter 3, it says, let the word of God, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom. Hallelujah. In all wisdom. And the wisdom of God is what? Is to ask. Is to ask. So after you've asked, now do what? Meditate on the target daily. Meditation is rolling it over in your mind and spirit. Hallelujah. in your mind and spirit. In the natural sense, if I'll use an example, meditation is the same thing as us worrying about certain things on our mind, but then this time around, replacing it with the word of God. Dwelling on certain things that have not happened in your life. You're meditating on the wrong things, but this time around, you are dwelling on the word of God. Hallelujah. When you meditate, you deal wisely in the affairs of life. Meditation makes a way if there is no way. Hallelujah. We meditate on the word till the word begins to speak to us. It begins to speak to us the same way. Some of us, maybe many of us have gone through that. You can meditate on, you know, something negative, you continue to meditate on it, and then that thing begins to speak to you. And once it begins to speak to you, you begin to act in a negative way. It's the same way. It's the same way. So when you meditate on the word day in and day out, it begins to speak to you, becomes a part and parcel of you. It begins to speak to you. It's very, very important that we meditate on it, because we feed our eyes, our ears, and our mouth with the word of God. And the words that you feed your heart through your mouth when you don't need them are the very same words that your heart will feed your mouth when you need them. The words that you feed your heart through your mouth when you don't need them are the very same words that your heart will feed your mouth when you need them. That is why you meditate on it daily, day and night. Hallelujah. That's God's advice, God's admonition to Joshua. He says you will meditate on it day and night, because it is through that you will have good success. It is through that you obtain direction. It is through that you obtain light. It is through that you become strong. You stand your ground. Hallelujah. You stand your ground. So like every hunter has a specific target in mind, he prepares himself before he goes. I think if you watch some of these hunting shows, you know, some of them wear this camouflage and all these dress and apparels and stuff like that. All that is preparation. They go there, they have some form of whistle. They do all those things because they want to have a successful hunt. It's the same way when you are pursuing the promises of God. You don't just go about it anyway. There is what you need to do. You can't just get up and say, I'm believing God for something. No, you have to go find it in the Bible. You have to go find it in the Bible. Then you have to believe what you found is yours. Then you settle with it. And after you've settled in your mind, your spirit, that this is mine, then you go to him, because it says his words are not returned unto him void. So you go to him, which his own word, to say, bring your strong proof. So you go to him with his word. This is what I have found. This is my rightful inheritance in you. So then you go and ask in prayer. And after that, you meditate on the target daily, 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 daily. Take instructions from it daily. And then your prophet appears unto all. Glory be to God. We will continue from here tomorrow. Hallelujah. Now let's go into our personal moment, our personal time with God. Hallelujah. Let's bring our petitions before him according to his will, according to his purpose, according to his plan for our lives. Let's go before him. He said he's the one who opened up his hands to satisfy the desire of every living thing. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus. We are all living things. So God must satisfy your desire this morning. Hallelujah. And he's the one that answereth all prayer. And the words is, unto him shall all flesh come. So this morning, go before him as you bring your petitions, your concerns. If you just want to talk to him, have a conversation with him, worship him, whatever you want to do, you are in his presence. He's here. He doesn't store our prayers. He answers them. That's what the Bible says. So let's do that, and we'll be back shortly.
to God. Glory to God. You know, with God, the Bible talks of the simplicity of the gospel. Then again, it talks of the foolishness of God. If you didn't complete that statement, you will wonder, foolishness of God. He said the foolishness of God is wiser than the wisest of men. Why that? Because sometimes what God is asking us to do looks too simple. And you wonder, will this be it? It's all that I've gone through, all that I'm going through, without my, how, you know, this situation is. But yes. Yes. Because God is not man. Is the possessor here. He says, just do it as I say it. And be diligent about it. If thou shalt diligently hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do according to all that I command thee this day. He said, then the Lord thy God shall set you up on high above all the nations of the earth. Just do. Locate. Find. Said, I've found your word as a man that find grace poised. Go on a search, seek ye out of the book of the law and read. None of this shall fail. It doesn't fail. It looks so simple, but it doesn't fail. Sit down, locate. Sit down, hunt, as he says. Sit down, find it. He said, and when thou hast found it, then there shall be a reward. It's your turn. It's your turn. Go get it. And you see how simply and cheaply it turns for you. It will turn for you. In Jesus' name. So as we go again today, let the peace of the Lord attend to us all. The peace of the Almighty. He said, the kind that the world does not understand, it will attend to you. In the name of Jesus. The peace of God will attend to you. It will keep you. In Jesus' name. Let's have Pastor Ernest close us today.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We thank God for another exciting time in his presence. We'll be back here again tomorrow morning, same time, for another refreshing time in his presence. Hallelujah. Now, as you go for this day, my prayer is that God remembers you. Hallelujah. God remembers your good deeds that you have done, you have sold in his house, in your workplace, to people. Hallelujah. Nehemiah said, remember me, O Lord, for the good deeds that he has done. So this morning, God, remember your good deeds and you'll be rewarded. The same way Mordecai's good deeds were remembered by the king and he was rewarded. The same way, this day, your good deeds be rewarded. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Have a wonderful and blessed day. No weapon of the enemy, no enchantment, no divination shall come near your dwelling place. You will have a fruitful and prosperous day. Talks about the righteous. If whatsoever he doeth, it shall prosper. So this day, you will only know prosperity in everything that you do, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's share the goodness of our Lord in closing. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Glory be to God. We'll be back here again tomorrow. Have a wonderful day. Jesus is still Lord.